What is the biggest decision you have ever made and how did you know it was right?
It's not about arranged marriage or love marriage. You can have love in arranged marriage as well.
What do you think that in today's world, is it better to run a business or have a job?
If I am a doctor and also I am rich also and I want to go abroad for job, that is better, or I do my practice here, that is better.
If you are a really talented doctor, if you are a really talented teacher, engineer or anything, do not leave your country, okay? Do something for your country.
How to invest, how to manage like money, invest and plan for the future?
Like if you have money but you don't have relation, you don't have anyone to care for you or to love you, you are empty inside.
What profession or career should we choose?
But it's not like that. If we are saving it or for our future, so it will be beneficial for our future. Not, we have to think about future as well.
Killing your desire is something else and saving money is something else.
What do you think about when making a big decision?
Like it could be possible that you are working in Korangi and you are living in Orangi town. So it will be very difficult for you to get there. Okay, like every single day you are moving from one place to other.
There are so many occupation and professionalism. I would say whatever you have to choose, you have to choose by yourself.
Decide your own destiny, otherwise someone else will do it for you. Think a lot about it.
What do you think we get married? Inside the family or outside it?
Like we should make a map where we want to go and then decide gradually, slowly where we want to go.
A decision can make anything, a bad thing or a good thing. So we have to do critical thinking as well, then we can have the good results.
So many people, they are just, you know, going for the white collar job, okay? But soft skills are softly taking the place of, you know, white collar job.
If somebody has money or anything like that, so we don't fall for that money. If he is not respecting you, what will you do?
So as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us in the Quran that good women for the good men and bad women for the bad men. So just focus on your career and clear your character, clear your deeds. Inshallah, the right person will come to you directly. Thank you so much.
Speaking style, behavior, okay, attitude, everything. You may go for the beauty as well, but the thing is that do not just cloud your decisions on the behalf of beauty.
It's often that girls always look for a rich man. So what do you think about that?
Like you can't live with a person who doesn't respect you.
I want to suggest you that if you are looking for a rich person, so of course go for the rich person, but the rich by the heart, not by the money.
They ask their daughter to get married to a rich person, but they do not count age difference.
What do you think about pursuing the right career as it is the major decision in the student life?
Every single body is going for that. Even we don't have the mind what to do and what not to do in the life. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. And may peace and blessing be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam and his family and his companion and all the Muslims around the world. Well, today we're going to have a wonderful discussion. And the discussion topic is major decisions of our life. Well, in many situations, we do not have critical thinking. Sometimes our emotions cloud our decisions. Sometimes we do not ask anyone when we are in a hard time. Especially in the case when we are making a major decision of our life. We never dare to ask our parents or our elders. So let's see what we are going to ask, different kind of questions going to be asked today. And especially we have our special guest today. Her name is Aman, and she's going to tell something about herself. So, okay, could you possibly introduce yourself?
Yes, sir. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. I hope you are doing well. Well, I'm gonna give you my short introduction. Myself, I'm Aman Yunus. I'm living in Karachi, Gulshan Iqbal. I have done my matriculation. My intermediate is in process. Well, I'm gonna give you my short story as well. Along with that, you know, I was a normal person like you all guys. But then once upon a time, my father told me that, are you interested in learning English? I told him yes. And he said like, My one of the friend is teaching English in office. So would you like to be interested? So I said, I'm interested, but I have so many questions. I'm confused. I'm a little bit shy. I'm a little not confident. So when I shared with Sir Khalid, he solved all of the problem in a very good manner. And now I'm here, you can see. Like all the person can be here like me. Only not specifically me, you all, like one day you will also be here, you will also be here, and I'm not the one who is here. And by the grace of Allah and with the help of Sir Khalid, I'm a supervisor in a company today. I was the one who never know English. I was the one. So I will say, if you have a teacher like Sir Khalid, so you should be the very grateful person of that. So you have to learn English and you have to show your complete interest with him. So thank you for listening my story.
Well, all the praises and thanks be to Allah. I am nothing, okay? So now you guys, please ask your questions, okay? She's not expert in consultancy, but she will share her paraview, okay? So definitely, inshallah, you are going to improve something. It's a win-win situation. You are going to improve your English, and also you are going to think about the different things that how we can make the decisions, especially major decisions of our life. Okay, so who is going to ask first question?
Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. I am Binish. My father's name is Abdul Rahim. I am doing ADC BCom Part 1. My question is, what profession or career should we choose?
You know, that's a nice question, and it depends on of us, like all of us, like what we are choosing. Like it's all about teaching, and in teaching there are so many occupation and professionalism. I would say whatever you have to choose, you have to choose by yourself. You don't have to be pressurized. Like if my mother wants me to like become a teacher, my father wants me to become a doctor, you have to choose your opinion first. So you have to choose your opinion. You don't have to choose anyone's opinion. If you want to be if you want to be a doctor, you have to be a doctor. You don't have to choose their opinion, because they don't have to study. You have to study by yourself, you know.
Well, in my take on, I would say, you know, this is in Pakistan, we are in a dilemma. Like sometimes, you know, I am a teacher, you know, so whenever I ask a student, most commonly they say, I want to become a doctor. But in the end, what they become, this is really a kind of, you know, grave issue. So we never know that who is going to become what, okay? But we should think about it, you know, first. Like we should make a map where we want to go, and then decide gradually, slowly, where we want to go. Getting my point? So this is why we, you know, are sitting over here talking. Critical thinking will help us a lot, and especially talking to our elders, because they are experienced. They will definitely help you to decide your career, okay? Also, we should think about the era. So many people, they are just, you know, going for the white collar job. Okay, but soft skills are softly taking the place of, you know, white collar job. So we never think about it. Okay, so this is my suggestion. You know, we should think, we should critically think. Then we should decide.
Assalamu alaikum to all. My name is Rabia. I have been learning English language for 5 months. So our today's discussion topic is major decision of our life. So big decisions can change our lives, choosing a career, getting married, or moving to a new place can be scary and almost, but also exciting. So I want to ask question, what do you think about when making a big decision?
Okay, first we should like think about all the thing, like a bad thing or good thing, anything can happen. Like a decision can make anything, a bad thing or a good thing. So we have to do critical thinking as well, then we can have the good results. I would say that.
Well, I think, you know, when making a decision, either it is major decisions or small decision, we should have critical thinking. We should also, you know, discuss with the other, with our elders and with our parents or with our friends, then we can make a perfect decision.
I want to say that first of all, if we want to make our decision in any kind of decision. So first of all, we should think about it and don't believe in hearsay. And also we should not be emotional, because nowadays it's a big problem with our youth generation. Our youth can get emotional, like too much emotional. That's why I want to say that.
Assalamu alaikum to all. My name is Afsa Rauf. I am doing 2 ADC BCom Part 1. Our topic is major decision of our life. I have a question. I have something. What do you think we get married? Inside the family or outside it?
Okay, that's a nice question that you asked me, that we should marry beside the family or outside the family. So I would say, like, when we are going to marry to someone, like, we have to choose it ourselves. Like, if somebody has money or anything like that, so we don't fall for that money. If he is not respecting you, what will you do? You can't do anything. So if someone is in your family and doesn't want to marry you, after marry you gotta know that he likes any one person, like he likes any other person, and you're going to marry him because of your family, and your, like, both of your life is getting destroyed, you know. It's all because of your family. So you gotta choose it by yourself. You have to, like, make your decision, because you're the one who can make your own decision. You're not a child. When you're gonna marry, you're not a child.
Well, I would say in this situation, this is a very critical situation when selecting your life partner, because it's the matter of life and death, I would say, you know. You will hit your head to the wall if you are married with someone you or he or she doesn't deserve, you know, getting married to you. So it's really major decisions of your life. So think a lot about it, okay? Never ever cloud your decisions. Even I would say, do not go for faces, okay? Don't ever consider dressing, in fact, you know? Sometimes, you know, we go for dressing that he or she dresses a wonderful way or this and that. So judge the person totally. Speaking style, behavior, okay, attitude, everything. You may go for the beauty as well, but the thing is that do not just cloud your decisions on the behalf of beauty. Okay, think about it, and then also, you know, share your, like, the person you are going to get married to, you have just, you know, thought about it. So also, you know, share with your parents, then they will also judge that person. Then you can get married to either he is in your family, means, you know, you're in relatives, or outside the relatives. The main thing is the person should be appropriate for you to get married to, okay?
Hey, Assalamu alaikum, this is Mohammed Kashan, and I want to share my perspective regarding Hafsa's question that you're asking, that we should get married inside the family or outside the family. So I would like to suggest you just focus on your career and make your character crystal like a mirror. So as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised us in the Quran that good women's for the good men and bad women's for the bad men. So just focus on your career and clear your character, clear your deeds. Inshallah, the right person will come to you directly. Thank you so much.
It's often that girls always look for a rich man. So what do you think about that?
Okay. And if a rich person doesn't respect you, what will you do after marrying him? What will you do? Like, you can't live with a person who doesn't respect you. He can't make effort for you. He can't happy you, like, he can't make you happy. He just can give you money, but he can't give you surprise or any gifts. Like, I would say, like, if a person is not rich and he is a poor guy, but is still making efforts for you, like, is still giving you cake or on your birthday, on your gift, and many kind of gifts, you know. So, like, the person is very mind-blowing.
Also take you to the ice cream shop.
Yeah, and if, like, you know, he's not able to make money for you, and he's not, like, he's just making efforts for you to make you happy, and he's not the one who is very rich, but he's still making happy. So I would say that like the one who is making efforts for you, and he's whether he is rich or not, he's a very mind-blowing person. But if someone is rich and, you know, he's not like doing any efforts for you, beating you, shouting on you, doesn't respect you, what will you do with him? You can't live with him. You will be mad.
I want to suggest you that if you are looking for a rich person, so of course go for the rich person. But the rich by the heart, not by the money. And it has a lot of respect instead of a lot of money. So inshallah, your life will be heaven. Thank you so much.
This is a valid question, and I would say a lot of Pakistani people, they make this terrible mistake. They ask their daughter to get married to a rich person, but they do not count age difference. I would request you guys, you know, listening me over here, Pakistani people, please consider the age as well, you know. In the end, she's going to hit her head to the wall, because age difference makes a huge difference, you know. So when considering, you know, getting married to someone, you should also, you know, think about it. Okay, thanks.
Assalamu alaikum to all. It's me, Sadia, here. I have been learning English for a month. Today topic is the major decision of our life. I would like to say that major decision can change our life. Before taking any decision, we must think about it. So my question is that, what do you think about pursuing the right career as it is the major decision in the student life?
Yeah, that's a very nice question. You know, like education is also important, career is also important. I would say, like, to getting a job, you have to make your career first. So it's all about the career. First, you have to choose education, good education. Then after that, you gotta choose your career. And after that, you gotta get a job. So you have to choose a good career for yourself. And you can, if you don't have any good career, like career in your mind, so you can get help from your parents, from your siblings. And if you don't have any, like, if you don't have any, you can ask them. Maybe they want you to become a doctor. So you can become them. And if you have your mindset, so you can become yours.
Well, pursuing a career is really major decision of our life. Obviously, we gotta think a lot about it, okay? A lot of people, they don't, you know, talk to someone and ask that, in this era, at this time, what study I should go for, okay? Even they are just using very old pattern. If somebody is doing, you know, MBA, everybody is going for that. If somebody is going for, you know, electronical engineering, every single body is going for that. Even we don't have the mind what to do and what not to do in the life. So decide your own destiny, otherwise someone else will do it for you. Think a lot about it. We do not think about our major decisions of life, but we think a lot about, you know, inflation, you know, and all of things, you know very well. So think about it a lot.
Okay, Eman, I have a question. It has been noticed that some of the people have their own house built by the ancestor. But what they do, they sell their house and they start living in the rented house. So what do you think that in this era, the person who has own house and he is selling it and going to the rented house, what do you think about this decision and this person?
You know, it's also kind of business, like when we are having our own house, but it's still selling that house and living on the like rent. So it's also like a business mind, you know, we are selling our own house in a good amount of money and also living in our rent and also making money for next home and gonna sell it in a future as well. I would say it's a good business mind, you know.
Well, it's a beautiful question. This is a problem of many people. Well, sometimes, you know, we should consider the situation. When we have, like, we have been given the house from our ancestors, but we have to, you know, divide it among, you know, our relatives, like brother, sister, and this and that, okay? So, in the end, we are left with a very less amount of money, okay? So, sometimes it's good, not good to sell the house. Okay, but we have to consider so many elements. We have to go for a critical thing that if I live, like it could be possible that you are working in Korangi and you are living in Orangi town. So it will be very difficult for you to get there. Okay, like every single day you are moving from one place to other. So it will be really difficult for you. So if you decide to sell your house from Orangi town and buy a new one in Korangi, that can make your life easier. So I would say this is, you know, up to you. You have to consider so many elements, then you can decide. Okay.
Miss Eman, I want to ask a question from you. How to invest, how to manage like money, invest and plan for the future?
sometime when we are like spending less amount of money, so everybody says like there is a miser person. Yeah, but it's not like that. If we are saving it or for our future, so it will be beneficial for our future. Not, we have to think about future as well. We don't have to see our present. We have to see our present. Yeah, like, but we don't have to see like if I like to eat Zinger Burger, I have a craving in night. So it's not like that. I have to spend my all of the money. You know, when money comes, so all the craving comes. So we have to save our money for the future. And it's good, like a good amount. Like we have to, you know, we have to save, but we don't have to like be a so much miser. We are not, spending money or anything like that. We don't have clothes to wear, but we're still not, buying that clothes. Being a so miser person. So this is my opinion, you know.
Well, she's rightly said that in many situations we should not be miser, you know. Spend like saving 100 rupees, 200 rupees or 1,000 rupees is not going to make a major change in your life. You should not sacrifice your desires all the time. You can save the money, but you should not kill your desires, okay? Killing your desire is something else and saving money is something else. But on the other hand, we should think about it that monthly how much we are saving. And also we should not go for saving all the time. We can also go for increasing our amount of earning. Why are we not developing our skills and enhance our earning, you know, capacity? Okay, so this is also we should consider.
Okay, Eamon, I want to ask that. Let's suppose there are two personalities. One person has a lot of money, a big house and big car, but he doesn't have a relation, like parents, children, something. In the other end, there is a personality, like he has a parents, obedient children, caring wife. So in your opinion, who is the true successful in both of them?
I would say if a person have a good family, a good relation with the, like their child, their wife, or with their mom and dad. So it's a very good life, you know, like you can make them happy in a less amount of money as well. You have to earn for yourself and you have to earn for yourself, and they're happy with you. But if a person have a lot of money but doesn't have a family, so what will he do with the money?
I asked the question because in the past we heard a lot of news, no? Like a brother kills his brother just because of a paper of their homes, and even people, you know, they are killing their parents too. Son become enemy of his father and his mother just because of he or she doesn't. So that's why I asked this question. So who is the most? Thank you so much for your opinion.
Want to say something?
Yeah. I just want to say that like if a person has like money or lots of money, what will he do in the end? He can't like he will be dying with the money. Will the money will be grave in his cupboard or what? What are you gonna do with that? Yeah, we have to die. One day we have to die.
Well, for this question, I would say having a perfect balance in of the life is really the good thing. Like if you have money, but you don't have relation, you don't have anyone to care for you or to love you, you are empty inside. You gotta have perfect balance of the life. You gotta have relations, you gotta have job, everything, you know. Balance of the life is really needed.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. My name is Nadeem Ahmed. I want to ask one question. If I am a doctor and also I am rich also and I want to go abroad for job, that is better, or I do my practice here, that is better?
I would say like going abroad and going studying over here, both of them is a like good. But you know, in Pakistan, we are not like making anyone specialized. You know, if someone is a master, if someone has master degree, if someone has graduation, if someone has MBBS degree, they say it's common. But it's in UK. But when we get a degree from UK, so they say like it's a very specialized person. Either he don't know anything, but he will say like it's a very good thing, like having a good degree by them or by their. But I would say like when we are studying over here. So we have to, like in Pakistan, I would say we have to make a rule. Like we have to, when we are studying over here, we have to see, we have to study over here, we have to practice over here. Then if we want to go abroad, we can go abroad as well.
Well, as you asked the question that the person has a decent amount of money, he is not poor, he's a good doctor. So I would highly suggest, guys, if you're a really talented doctor, if you're a really talented teacher, engineer, or anything, do not leave your country, okay? Do something for your country. If you are rich, then why are you going there? Okay, to serve the different country people. You were born over here, you grew over here, you studied over here, so why are you leaving? Okay, if you don't have solid reason, don't ever make this decision. This is not for you. Pay for your country, okay?
I want to ask you a question. What is the biggest decision you have ever made and how did you know it was right?
Okay, to switching a job, I would say I have ever made a biggest decision was leaving my first job. I was working there for 1 year and then I left from over there with my own opinion. Nobody pressurized me to go from over there, but it was my own opinion. Then I would say it was a very changes opinion in my life. Like I made a decision, then I got to get a person. After that, everything happens. After that, I got to know someone who is waiting for me in my life.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Mursa and I live in Gulshan Ekbar and I study in class 9. So my question is, what do you think that in today's world, is it better to run a business or have a job?
Okay, he got a very nice question. Well, I would say when you do a job, so you do job for your business, future. Once you got to know about somehow for the job, then you got to have that business. I'm doing a job in call center field. Once I don't know about agent, processing, anything like that, how can I be a boss? And when I don't know anything, I have to know. I got to know everything, then I can be a boss. So I got to know each and everything when I'm doing job, then I can have a business.
What do you think is the best gift of parents can give their children to a best education and a best life partner or a strong financial background?
Okay, well, I would say the best gift by parent is that they are growing you, they are paying on you, they are making money for you, they're doing everything for you. So this is a very precious gift by them, you know.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Sayyar Al Ali. My question is, what do you think, arranged marriage is better or love marriage?
But I would say it's not about arranged marriage or love marriage. You can have love in arranged marriage as well. Like after arranged marriage, you gotta love that person. After nikah, you know, this is in Islam, we say after nikah, in three words, we say kabul hai. After that, we gotta love that person. We have to live with that person. They are our madam, or you know, you have to. You can. When we are in love with someone, so we don't have to marry with the other person. So it's destroying both of our life. And we're gonna tell them, yes, I love a person. I can't marry you. So we have to discuss with them as well. We have to share our point, you know.
Well, it's a beautiful question, but really difficult questions to answer because so many elements are involved in that. But I would say, you know, one thing, that either you go for arranged marriage or love marriage. Select a right person for you.
Assalamu alaikum everyone. This is me, Hassan Khan, and I have been learning English over here for 3 months. And our topic is that major decision of our life. And I have a question for you. What is the useful education in today's world? It is commerce or science or medical?
Yeah, that's a nice question you asked. Well, I would say in choosing a subject like a commerce and computer science and what you said, biologic, I would say when we are interested in such subject, like I would say if you're not interested in biology, how can you learn that? You have to see your perspective. You have, like, you don't have to see like Ratta or anything like that. You will see like when you will become a doctor. So when you don't know anything about biology, you just do it Ratta or anything like that. So how will you like teach, how will you treat your patient? How will you gonna treat him? You have to first you have to, you don't have to see what people are doing, what world is going. You have to see your perspective.
Well, in the end, I would say, you know, it's is really the major decision of your life when you are deciding your career. Yeah. When you are deciding your career, exactly, actually, you are deciding your studies. On behalf of your studies, you become what you want to become in the future. So select your interest first. Check it out in which field you are interested in. Your passion should be there. Your passion lead you there you want to go. If you are not passionate enough to learn, to devote yourself in any kind of field, you can make the money, but you cannot just, you know, touch the heart of so many people or help the other. You will not be able to help the other.